조금 맞추면 you are good. You are okay. Mathematics time. Oh, it's time for mathematics. But before we look at, oh, we have our mathematics. We don't fail to remind ourselves about COVID-19, this pandemic which has become a problem to all of us. That we should keep a distance. When you move out with mommy, daddy, don't get involved where very many people are contagious. Please keep a distance. And don't forget to put on your mask. I know you put on your mask very well. But when you are putting it on, make sure you don't make it that you hold it and put it on very well. Keep it clean. Don't wear a dirty mask, please. It will harm you more. Make sure you put it on very well. I will put on mine, but because I want you to get me clearly, that's why it is aside. And I have no people around me. So, COVID is there. Don't take it lightly. As we say that it's our time for mathematics, our last lesson was about finding the place values of some digits or of numbers. But we're going to review or to remind ourselves. We are going to remind our source of looking for the place values of some numbers or of some digits. I'm giving you an example. I see whether I still remember of how to get the place values of some numbers. If you are given a number 2, 3, 1, and I want you to look for the place value of the underlying number, we are reminding ourselves, and we are looking for the place value of the underlying number of the circled number, excuse me, sorry. You might have those two words. Underlining is when you put a line. Then circling is when you put a ring around the number. Now mine is circled. What is the place value of this number, if you still remember very well? We look at the place values as tens, ones, tens, and hundreds. We need to go to thousands. We stopped at hundreds. So, what is the place value of this circled number? We said that place value of the circled number, we have our hundreds, tens, and ones. So as we are putting the place value, the one which is circled, it will be in the place of, or it is in the place of ones. Do we still remember very well? That is one example. Let me add you another example that I see. If I give you 1, 4, 2, and now you are looking for all digits place values, this one, this one, and this one. These two examples I have. What is the place value of 2? It is 1s. Then the place value of 4? It is 10s. Then the place value of 1? It is 100s. So if you still remember all this, there you are in time. If I come here on top, can you put the place values on top? We position. This one stands for ones. Then four is in the place of ten, sorry. Then one is in the place of 100. Do they match with this ones? Two is in the place of ones. Four in the place of tens. One is in the place of the hundreds. Hope we still remember this. So today's lesson, we are going to look at finding, I'm using another of term, finding the values. Finding the values. Here it was the place value, but here now we are going to look at the value or the values of the digits or of the numbers of any digits in a number. We are to look for or to find the values of digits in a certain number. How do we find that value? We find the value of each number, each digit in a number. We find, you must understand this. We find the value of, we find the value of each digit. Each digit, you are asking me, what is a digit? You mean, look at the word digit, of each digit in a number. I'm going to explain it more. In a number, by multiplying. Understand this statement, my dear children. By multiplying each, by multiplying the digits, by its place, value. We are reading together. We find the value of each digit in a number by multiplying the digit by its place value. When I talk of a digit in a number, back here I have this number which is 231. This is a digit, and one is also a digit in this whole number. I don't know whether you understand me. Here, when we come to example number 2, where we reminded ourselves, I have this number as 142. 142. 1 is a digit in 142. 4 is a digit in 142. 2 is a digit. So, when you come up here, we say, find the value of each digit in a number is by multiplying the digit by its place value. How are we going to do it and what does it mean, teacher, this statement? Examples. Pay attention and sit upright. Examples. Number one. Before we write a digit, I have my place values. That is, let me begin with the tens and the ones. And I have these digits. I have 2 as a digit, 3 as a digit. In this number, the whole number is 23. My number is 23. So 2 is a digit. I want you to understand the word digit as we say it. 3 is a digit. So what do we mean by multiplying it by its place value? 3 is in the place value of 1s. 2 is in the place value of 2. So how are we going to multiply? When we get this number here, 3, the value of 3 is 3, we said, we find the value of each digit in a number, 3, in this number, by multiplying. I'm going to get 3, I multiply it as a digit by its place value. What is the place value of 3? The place value of 3 is, I hope you know, as 1s, as 1s. How do I write? I write it as 1, in figure, not in a word. So, what is 3 times 1? What is 3 times 1? We know very well that 3 times 3 groups of 1 is 3. When I do part of 1 aside, when we do our part of 1, 3 groups of 1, it will give us 3. To give us, if I do part of my work, 3 groups of 1. 1, 1, 1. What will it give us? It will give us 3 as a part of 1. I come to this one. Before I go to this one, what is the value of 3 as a digit in the 23? The value of 3 is 3. Because we've got 3, we multiply it by 1 as a place value. And we got 3. We come to 2 as a digit. We get each digit. We multiply it by its place value. What is this now? It is 2 as a digit. Excuse me. We multiply it by its place value. And what is the place value of 2? It is 10. Do I write a word? No. We write the figure. So it will be 2 times 10. And what is 2 groups of 10? We looked at all this. 2 bundles of 10. What does it give us? It will give us, if I'm to do it here, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, where should I put it? 10. Another 2. Another group of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many groups of 2? I need 10. 2 groups of 10. They will give us, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. To give us 20. So what is the value of 2 in this figure? After multiplying it by its place value, we'll get 20. So 20 is the value of 2. Here 3 is the value of 3. If I am to do it very well, excuse me, if I am to do it very well, you get the bundles of, let's say, sticks. When you're at home there, there are very many. You can get straws. You do it very, very well. And you get the value of each digit in a number. Example 2. Example 2. I have 1, 3, 4. 134. 134, the books. 134. But they want us to get the value of each digit in that number. The value of each digit in that number. Thank you very much. The value of each digit in that number. What did we say? We say to find the value, we get the digit, we multiply it by its place value. We place the values up. The value of, I mean the place value for is 1s. Then here it is 10. It's 4. Then here it is 100s. multiplicate, for as a digit, we multiply it by its place value. And you see, what do we get? We get 4. We multiply it by 1s. And what do we get? What is 4 times 1? Any number multiplied by 1 is that number. We still remember that. Any number multiplied by 1 is that number. And we say, any number multiplied by 0 is 0. Even if you get 100 things multiplied by 0, you get 0. You get 1,000,000 multiplied by 0, you get 0. You get 1,000,000 multiplied by 1, you get 1. You get that million. So any number multiplied by 1 is that number. So what is 4 groups of 1? Is 4. We count this one. So we say we get the digit. We multiply by its place value, that is 3. Times, what is the place value of 3 now? It is 10. We say we don't write 10s in a word. We write a figure. So what is 3 groups of 10? What is 3 groups of 10? 3 bundles of 10. They will give us 30. They will give us 30. You do it very well. So what is the value of 3 in this number? It is 30. We come to this one. This one is. Can you use a ruler? Now, we come to the last thing. Digit in 134. We say you will get 101, which is in the place of 100. You multiply it by 100. We did these things when you were drawing bundles. What is 1 times 100? We'll get 100. We say any number multiplied by 1 is that number. So 1 times 100, it is 100. 1 times 50, it is 50. 1 times 1,000,000, it is 1,000,000. Hope we are together. So what is the value of 1 in 134? The value of 1 in 134 is 100. You see, finding the value is so simple, so easy, if you just know how to multiply. In fact, example, as mathematicians, we don't forget to draw our 2 lines or double lines and make our work on it. Here I didn't draw because it was standing there, but the last example, let me give you 282. Now, we say in first position there, according to their place values, I'm putting here is also 1s, 10s, then so, and we begin. We say we get the digit, we multiply by its place value. What is the place value of 2? We get 2 as our digit because we are looking for its value. We multiply it by 1. What is 2 times 1? This is so simple. The answer is 2. Because we say any number multiplied by 1 is that number. Two groups of 1, you see? 2. Then we come to this one. What is this figure? Or what is this digit? It is 8 as a digit. We multiply it by its place value, which is 10. And what do we get? What is 8 groups of 10? We said when we have 8 bundles of 10. I wanted it to have them here. 8 bundles of 10. Please get markers like this. 8 sticks. You count for me 8 bundles. Hurry up. 8 bundles of 10. And what have we got? and how many you get. Can you read very fast for me? If you have a lot of things that come to you around there, you get it. Two groups of 100. This is 100 plus 100. They will give you 200 within these things. So what is the value of 2 in 282? The value of 2 in 282 is 200. Are we clear? Thank you for that participation. Now let's have our activity. Our activity number one. Find the place value. Stay safe. Be aware.